Merry Christmas to everyone joining us here at 2K Sports. It's time for a special presentation of the NBA on Christmas Day. Hi, everyone. I'm Brian Anderson, along with Grant Hill and Brent Berry, our distinguished analyst, Ali LaForce on the sidelines. And here's what the Milwaukee Bucks schedule looks like. On Sunday, they kick off a road trip to New York, where they'll take on the Knicks. Then on Tuesday, they'll be matching up with Jimmy Butler and the Miami Heat. Before we get started, we've got just enough time to head over to the sideline. Allie?
Well, guys, Giannis Antetokounmpo has left no doubt he wants to be one of the best ever. At the same time, he understands what it takes to achieve greatness. He said, quote, "I've got to be locked in every night because at the end of the day, if you don't win, it really doesn't matter." Back to you, B.A.
Ah, squad goals, Allie. Thank you. And early on in the season, you can see some rookies still trying to deal with the speed of the NBA. Brent, how was that transition for you?
My situation was a little unique, B.A., in that my brother John had already played three seasons in the NBA, and a lot of my offseason happened to be around games where NBA players were readying themselves. But guys who don't get that experience, they get an appreciation for just how good the talent is, 1 through 15, on NBA rosters.
The starters for the Golden State Warriors. Andrew Wiggins is out there with Stephen Curry. Then it's Wiseman, then there's Eric Paschal, and it's Oubre in at the three. And for Milwaukee, inside we got Giannis and Lopez. DiVincenzo is the two, with Middleton playing the three. And it's Holiday in at the point guard position. Outside Paschal. Five to shoot. Golden State needs to get off a shot. The three from Curry. The shot won't fall. Middleton outside, DiVincenzo on the wing. Pass to Antetokounmpo. 13 feet out. No good off the back of the rim. Now here's Wiggins. He chipped in with 13 points in his last game. Outside Curry, fires the three. That one goes. Now he's one for two.
A thing of beauty, Steph Curry shot from distance, pure.
And here are the Bucks now. It's a three-point game. First chance of the year for them to go up against this Warriors team.
Last year, they made easy work of this club, sweeping the two-game season series.
Sort of representative of how they each finished the season. One a playoff team, the other on the outside looking in. I think things may play out the same way this year, too.
Now here's Curry. His last outing, he had 20. Pass to DiVincenzo. On the wing, Holiday. And here is Antetokounmpo. Gets his second attempt to go. Now he's one for two.
Well, this is where Giannis does all of his damage. He gets inside the paint, has the size to work you back, and then stretch out and score.
And a deep three from Curry. Rebounded by Lopez.
He's not the guy that you want to give a wide-open look from three-point range. They're lucky that that one doesn't cost them.
DiVincenzo finds Antetokounmpo. And here's Lopez. Knocked loose. Curry against Holiday. Pass to Wiseman. Now here's Wiggins. Shot clock at five. Paschal, a screen on DiVincenzo. Nails it from three.
Hey, when he's hitting that shot, it really helps the spacing for this team.
Yeah, no question. When he is connecting from those kind of spots on the floor, it is just a huge boost for what they can do offensively.
Middleton outside. Out to DiVincenzo. The three is up. Warriors with the rebound. Now Curry. Holiday against Wiggins. Outside, DiVincenzo fires the three. Up again. Great positioning on the putback.
And Giannis just gobbling up the rebound, just spreads his wing out there and ball falls right into it.
Curry against Holiday. Pass to Antetokounmpo. Got it. Golden State has gone 2-of-4 from distance to begin this one. Holiday's been in the league for roughly a decade now, and throughout, he's been reliable and he's been consistent.
Yeah, B.A., his scoring average has gone up a little over time. But you look at almost every other category, assist, rebounds, steals, shooting percentages, you know what Holiday is going to give you year in and year out.
Lopez, that won't go. Misses his first shot of the game.
The defense is tough as it comes right there. He's a hard man to deny when he gets the ball to the rim.
Antetokounmpo against Pascal. No luck on that one, and Milwaukee will come the other way. Pass to Lopez. Throws it up high! Curry with it. He has 6. Now Wiggins lets the 3 fly. Antetokounmpo grabs the board. Here's Middleton. And it's Wiseman with the rebound. Wiseman's got 4 rebounds in the game. Right side Curry. Over Holiday. And again, no good by Golden State. Milwaukee has gone 0-for-2 from outside. Outside, DiVincenzo. Outside, Holiday. And it's out of bounds to the Bucks as Milwaukee retains possession. A different look for Milwaukee. Portis comes in for Lopez. And it's Connaughton in for DiVincenzo. The Warriors also with a sub. Chris has checked in. Here's Antetokounmpo. 6 points for him. Wiggins outside. Takes a 3, bearing his 2nd of 3 attempts.
Now, what a great option he gives them on every possession.
Both teams deciding to change it up.
They're just giving away a run right now. The question is, can they stop the tide?
Hard to say right now. At this point, I've seen the coaches run through 2 or 3 iterations of defense. Is there a 4th? I'm not sure.
And he'll take a trip to the line for 2. Clearly got fouled on that shot.
In Milwaukee, Wisconsin, that's Giannis's 2nd home, of course, after Athens, Greece. I mean, he truly has become a man here and has said he would love to finish his career as a Buck.
He's off on the first. You know, Brent, when Giannis was drafted back in 2015, he was the youngest player in the league.
Well, he didn't know how to drive a car. I'm sure he's having some problems with the finances, going from the euro to the U.S. dollar. And there was just a ton of things for him not only to learn in the game of basketball, but culturally here in the United States. But you got to give it to him. He's been a sponge. He's wanted to be the best player in the league since he got here, and he might be that now. And as much talk as we can get into about Giannis and his improvement on the floor with his skills, it's really the type of work he puts in behind the scenes in the weight room. I mean, think about this, adding over 50 pounds of muscle since he's entered the league. That's a new kind of player we're seeing.
Looney, the screen. He takes it in, and a two-handed jam!
Now that's how you capitalize on a screen.
Yeah, good positioning too. Gave him a clear path to the hoop.
Really not enough help there. Lack of communication on the backside.
And the way Giannis likes to play, getting downhill, none of that added strength goes to waste, Brent.
Well, he loves to get in there and flex a little bit, and with that length, it's kind of hard to understand defensively maybe where some of those arms and legs are coming at you with. You end up fouling Giannis, and he ends up doing some serious damage.
Here's Wanamaker. Pass to Wiggins. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Wiggins has always had a knack for that. Get inside, force the D to commit, and draw the foul.
First one falls for him. That one falls, so he hits both of them. The Bucks trail. Pass to Portis. Here's Craig. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Right wing. Four on the clock. Forbes can't get it to go. The Warriors have gotten 50% of their shots to fall so far. They're 5 of 10. From down in the low post, it goes.
And this defense needs to turn the screws and ramp up the intensity. They're looking a little loose out there right now.
Pass to Connaughton. And the Bucks miss again. Golden State with the ball. They're on an 18-7 run. Here's Wanamaker. And it's off from three-point range. Milwaukee has gone 0 for 4 from deep to start this one. Now Portis. He's defended by Looney. Portis with it. Looney's there. So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
Man, he made sure to get his money's worth on that foul.
First free throw is good. Augustine, he's checked in for Forbes. Both good from the line that time. Here's Bazemore. .146 left to play in the first. Pass to Chris. Here's Bazemore. There's a screen. And here's Chris. And so the ball out of bounds. Antetokounmpo touched it last.
Just a millisecond late. So close to coming up with a steal there.
Real close, and I'm sure next time you might time that a little bit better and get a hand on it.
Minute 32 left in the first quarter of the game. The jumper from the wing off target. Well, Milwaukee's shooting 23%. Not great so far. Driving in, Craig. Looney grabs a miss. Golden State has gone 4 of 8 from outside in this first quarter. Here's Wanamaker. It's good. And he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play opportunity. And that one misses. Milwaukee with the ball. They trail by 11. Here's Connaughton. Misses the three. The Warriors have gone 7 of 14 and looking in control. Down low. Here's Chris. That one no good. Great D that time from Antetokounmpo. And so it's Milwaukee with it. Pass to Craig. Here's Portis. He's defended by Looney. Pulls it from 20. Warriors with the rebound. They come into this one following a loss to Brooklyn.
It seemed like they were forcing shots, and the shooting percentage reflected that.
Yeah, I'll say anytime you're having trouble getting over that 40% field goal mark, it's probably not going to be your night.
Over to the wing. Pass to Craig. Here's Augustine. Offline with a three. And an overpowering first quarter effort. Already a double-digit advantage. The Warriors on top. They lead by 11. And we'll be back in just a minute with the start of the second quarter. And when asked to compare himself to LeBron James, Giannis...
I know if I put the work in, maybe 10 years from now I can be the same standards. But I gotta put the work in, and whenever I face him, I gotta show up. I cannot be taking day off against him.
And that's the humble, hard-working approach we've come to expect from Giannis.
It's almost like he's not interested in putting himself on a pedestal. Enough people do that for him. He just wants to become the best he can be and win rings.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. Boy, for the Warriors, this has been the game they've wanted to have.
Well, you have to credit their effort on the defensive end. It set the tone for this contest.
That defense has been infectious here as everybody stepping up aggressively on that end.
So on the floor for Golden State, we've got Kelly Oubre. Wiseman is out there with Eric Paschal. Then there's Stephen Curry, and it's Poole in at the two. Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket.
Pass to Lopez. Back to Portis. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws. That'll be on Eric Paschal.
The defense there doing whatever they can to protect the rim.
All right, Grant, how much did the elimination of hand and body checking in the early 2000s really change the game?
Yeah, B.A., it had a huge impact on the game. If you recall, in the 90s, a lot of the games were slugfests. The scores would be in the low 80s at times because the hand checking and the physicality, it really became a defensive game. But since they eliminated that and allowed for freedom of movement in the game, it's really highlighted the excellence and great play of the offensive players in the NBA. And as a result, scoring's up. It's fun to watch, fans are more engaged, and overall, a fun game to participate in and to watch.
And so he makes both from the line. Second quarter of basketball, about a minute played so far. Wiggins outside. The three from Curry. Rebounded by the Bucks. Lopez has got five rebounds in the game. Holiday passes to Lopez. Now here's Portis. Pass to Holiday. 5 on the clock. From behind the arc. Gets the three ball to go.
That's a beautiful shot there for Drew. Defenses have to account for Drew Holiday out there behind the arc.
Outside Curry. Wiggins passes to Paschal. It's stolen by Holiday. Middleton against Oubre. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Middleton out there thinking about the game, and that helps out. Skilled at getting to the free throw line. I know Coach Bud has encouraged Chris Middleton to look more and more to the three, but a leopard doesn't change his spots. And Chris Middleton loves to do damage from the mid-range. He can be efficient from both.
First one falls, and Middleton, a smooth score, especially for a player of his size, Brent.
And that frame, B.A., helps him out a ton. As soon as a player gets on his hip that's smaller than him, Chris can decide when to go up and where it is that he's going to do his damage from.
And the Warriors making a change here. Bazemore's checked in. He makes one or two that time.
The versatility Middleton offers up is exceptional. A capable defender, a good scorer, an effective shooter. Those are the kind of switchblade players the coaches love.
Take a break. Two shots.
No good on that one. And he sinks the second. Second quarter of play with around 2 minutes gone so far. Outside Holiday. And it's Wiseman with the rebound.
Nice rebound. Trying to match the other team's intensity right now.
Here's Curry. Drilled from 11 feet out. Curry's got 5 points now in the quarter.
You got to guard the long-range ball, but Steph's so good at pulling up. Great footwork and foundation. A good job on the pull-up, Jay.
Now here's Holiday. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two. And the first one at the line is good. And Grant, you played all 4 years at Duke. Nowadays, it's so often one and done. And in a year or two, maybe straight out of high school. Your thoughts on that?
Well, first of all, yes. If you played all 4 years in college nowadays, you're almost penalized for that, which is really weird. But I think when you look back in 2005 and they eliminated the straight out of high school and implemented the one and done rule, teams didn't really have the proper resources to handle the influx of young players. But since that time, the staffs, the player development on and off the court are better suited now to help these kids adjust and transition from high school or 1 year of college right into the NBA. So I see straight out of high school coming back, and I think the league is better prepared for that when it happens.
Yeah, and the G League is a major part of that as well. Now here's Lopez. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Here's Middleton. Oh, nice D from Curry. Golden State has gotten 6 of 11 threes to go in this game. Oubre can't hit.
Well, they shouldn't be giving that shot to anyone, but they certainly shouldn't be giving it to him. That's a big break for the defense.
Holiday passes to Lopez. Portis with it. Oubre picks him up. Clock at 6. Pass to Holiday. 4-3. He's got it. Just 2 of 7 from the field, though.
It took a little bit of time, but now he's taking the pen off the cap and putting his mark on this game.
Back to Curry. Here's Bazemore. Defended by Portis. And that one, good. Curry's got 10 points in the quarter.
Kent Bazemore knows that his contributions come from being active and Bazemore becoming a better passer.
Timeout called, the Bucks. Man, it's been quite a game for Stephen Curry.
Not sure what the defense is thinking or if they are. They continue to let him shoot. That is bad defense.
And the Bucks making a change here. DiVincenzo's checked in. Portis, the pass to Holiday. Back to Portis. Pass to Holiday. Outside, DiVincenzo. That one falls. Nice feed that time from Holiday. DiVincenzo's got himself on the board with a three there. Here's Wiseman. Back to Curry. And here's Oubre. From the arc. They get the rebound. Back to Curry. The three. Rebounded by Lopez. Lopez has got his sixth rebound on the night. Middleton outside. DiVincenzo on the wing. Pass to Lopez. From 7 feet. And the Bucks getting another bucket right there.
Lopez powering through that time.
Golden State has gone 2 of 5 from deep here in the second. Here's Curry. Oh, the teardrop falls in. Curry's got 12 points now in the quarter.
Defense shaking their heads. No idea how to stop him in this quarter. He's got him on the ropes.
Middleton outside and out of bounds. The Warriors will take it.
Yeah, the body language right now is not looking good for this basketball team. The game might be out of reach, but they have to avoid mistakes like that.
And the Bucks with some changes. Giannis Antetokounmpo's checked in for Portis, and it's Connaughton in for Middleton. Looney's checked in for the Warriors. Chris comes in for Oubre. Now here's Looney, looking for his first basket still in this one. And Curry is good for three. And the Warriors lead by 11.
And their offensive execution has really picked up here in the second period.
Here's Holiday. And Holiday powers it home.
You know Drew Holiday is a guard, right? You know he can handle the ball, right? On the screen.
On the wing, Curry. 21 points in the game. Back to Wiggins. And they immediately answer back with a dunk on the other end.
I just love the strong finish there inside.
Man, he's got that dunker's mindset, doesn't he? Always ready to pounce. Now here's Holiday. He's got 10, and the shot goes down.
This is a one-man show right now. He's on a mission to get him out of this hole.
Gives us a chance to catch up with Ali LaForce.
Brian, the Elam ending is a new concept that the NBA has tried out. Down the stretch, you turn off the clock and you play to a target score, much like a pickup game at the park. Chris Paul was the one who actually suggested trying it out in last year's All-Star game, and it was a rousing success. So we'll see how far it goes.
Great idea. Good stuff, Ali. Thank you. Now here's Antetokounmpo. 35 points his last game, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Antetokounmpo has got 9.
Antetokounmpo, those long strides and then fearless in his attack.
Curry finds Wiggins. Here's Bazemore. Here's Curry. It's deflected. And here is Antetokounmpo. 9 points in the game. Back to Lopez. Pass to Connaughton. 6 to shoot. Outside Holiday. Golden State has gone 7 of 14 from the perimeter in this one. Here's Wiggins. And that'll be Golden State's ball as it goes out of bounds. Warriors able to keep possession. And the Warriors call time here. Well, Grant, you've been part of the Atlanta Hawks ownership group for years now. What drew you to that?
Well, B.A., I've always thought about the idea of being a part of an ownership team. And in 2015, when the Atlanta Hawks became available, I was able to put together a group and acquire the team. And I'll tell you, it's been fantastic. First of all, I've learned a great deal. There's some incredibly difficult decisions that are made year in and year out on the business side and on the basketball side as well. But I tell you, it's been nothing but fun. I've enjoyed it, great partners, and I look forward to bringing a championship to Atlanta one day.
Here's Toscano. The shot, no good. And Milwaukee will come the other way. Outside Augustine. Off with the layup. Golden State has gone 3 of 6 from outside in the second quarter. Pass to Wanamaker. Out to the right wing. 1:19 left to play in the first half. Rejected by Antetokounmpo. Outside Augustine. To the paint. Here's Lopez. It's tipped.
That's some good use of the length right there from Marquese Chris, reaching out and swatting that one away.
To the middle. Their offense stone cold. Another miss there. Antetokounmpo outside. Tries the spin move. Shot from 16. Warriors with the rebound. They've led by as many as 14. Here's Wanamaker. Pass to Toscano. Here's Wanamaker. From downtown. It's hauled in by Connaughton. Now here's Antetokounmpo. Connects from downtown.
Yeah, Giannis has the hard hat on right now, going to work. So good, so long, just terrorizing the deep.
And the first half comes to an end. We've got a close game going here. The Warriors on top, up by 4. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson. Shaq is here. Kenny's here. You're watching the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. The first half was all about Stephen Curry. He had 21 points and 1 rebound. It is all happening for him so far tonight. An incredible first half performance. Taking a look at the Warriors, Kenny, what'd you think?
Well, they were lighting it up from 3, and that was the difference in the first half. They did a good job of running off screen, spotting up, and getting rid of the ball quickly. And their shot selection, solid.
And you, big fella, let's get your thoughts on the Bucks.
The thing I like is their aggressive approach and getting to the line. You know, when things seem to stagnate on offense, it's sometimes a matter of forcing your will. This team can generate a lot of points and also dictate the pace of the game if they play with that aggressiveness.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final.
Horn. Oh, buzzer.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple of quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. Stephen Curry having a dominant impact in this game.
Can they come up with an answer for him coming out of the half? They have to change something defensively.
Yeah, just way too easy out there, and I'm sure coach is going to make that a priority at halftime.
And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. Middleton is the 3 with Giannis playing the 4. Dante DiVincenzo out there with Drew Holiday. And it's Lopez in at the center position. That's the group for Milwaukee right now. Now here's Antetokounmpo. He gets it in there. Antetokounmpo has got 14 points.
Well, an outstanding floor general right there. Holiday has switched between point guard and off guard. And a great feel for when guys are open.
Curry finds Wiggins. Pascal with it. Back to Wiggins. They set the pick. Got a piece of it.
Excellent off-ball awareness as Brook was able to get over there and swat it away.
Here's Wiggins. He's got 11. Rebounded by Lopez. Lopez has got rebound number 8 here already in the game. Pass to Antetokounmpo. Middleton outside. Just 5 on the clock. This for the tie. Here's Antetokounmpo.
They've really picked up the energy level and have willed themselves back into this game.
Well, they didn't really have a choice at the position that they were. They had to fight hard. They've gotten that. They've outworked the other team just fighting tonight.
Oubre passes to Curry. No good with the triple. For Milwaukee, they've got 2 of 3 from the floor in this third quarter. Back to Middleton. Pass to Lopez. And here is Antetokounmpo. For the lead. Let's it fly. And that one's long. The Warriors have gone 0 for 3 to start the second half. Into the third. 2 minutes in now. Holiday against Curry. Buries it from three. Curry's got 24 points.
Yeah, I feel like the ball really isn't even getting anywhere close to the rim. It's all cotton right now.
You know, Brent, now he's entering his mid-30s. What do you think may change with Stephen's game, if anything?
I think he's just going to fall off the cliff. I'm kidding. Obviously, this guy is one of the greatest shooters of all time. And they say that you get better as a shooter as you get older. Is that humanly possible with Steph Curry? I don't think so.
Now here's Wiggins. He's got 11. It's tipped. With the floater. Good work defensively by Lopez. The Bucks have gone 3 of 5 from the field in this third quarter. Outside Holiday. Pass to Antetokounmpo. For the lead. And another three for Milwaukee.
Something sapped them of their energy defensively since halftime. In the first half, out there scrambling, running, hustling. Since then, not so much.
Now here's Oubre. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Pass to Pascal. There's the three. Counted from distance.
It's clear there's a lot of pride on the line in this one.
Not always the best scenario, but in this game, pride takes over. You score on me, I'm going to come back and score on you.
Now here's Lopez. Now Holiday. Back to Antetokounmpo.
Well, the D really getting away with one there. No one on him, and that's going to be good 9 out of 10 times.
On the wing, Curry. Over Holiday, and a foul called on the way up. So he'll take 2 from the free throw line. It's on Drew Holiday.
Yeah, don't let the small size fool you. Curry does not fear getting inside and getting knocked around.
One falls for Curry. Boy, one area where Curry often doesn't get enough credit, Grant, his effort on defense.
You know, B.A., he really does try on the defensive end. And he can be very effective against players his size, but he also brings that fight to bigger players. Even when they try to post him up, Curry has heart and he takes the challenge seriously.
And he can't hit the second.
He does enough to give them the lead. Every point critical here with the game in the balance.
Antetokounmpo is doubled. Here's Forbes. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
It was a strong move. The shot's just a little off.
Shooting 2.
And he knocks down the first one. No good on the second, so he hits 1 of 2.
Couldn't put them in the lead, but at least does enough to tie it up.
Pass to Wiseman. Here's Bazemore. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up. They pin that one on Giannis Antetokounmpo. He misses the free throw. He hits the second from the line. Here's Antetokounmpo. He's got 16. Pass to Forbes. Back to Antetokounmpo. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Now, hard to get upset at the defense there. Antetokounmpo is no easy matchup down low in the paint.
Shooting two.
First free throw is good.
What improvement we saw during Giannis Antetokounmpo's first few years in the league. Went from raw to ridiculous in a hurry.
Connaughton, he's checked in for Holiday. Second free throw, no good.
He was able to tie it up, but he has to be disappointed that he could not give his team the lead.
Pass to Curry from outside the arc. Knocks down the triple. Curry's got seven now in this quarter.
Exactly what every offense needs. Shooters who can force the defense to extend.
Well, there's no doubt he's a legitimate threat from downtown, and he's demonstrating that in this game.
Well, that was clearly a foul.
Shooting two.
And he knocks down the first one. So he hits one of two from the stripe.
They're missing a chance to trim the lead by leaving points at the line.
Shot is good by Curry.
Down the stretch, he's been flat out awesome. He helped them get the lead, and now he's making sure they keep it.
Timeout, timeout. Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. Man, it's been quite a game for Stephen Curry.
Well, they got to be using this timeout to think about a personnel change or a game plan change to try to slow him down.
to the left side wing. Portis gets the bucket. Portis has got 7 points.
Yep, that's a great look from Giannis there.
Here's Curry. Give him 31 now. Into the lane. Banked it in off the glass. Curry's got 12 now in this quarter.
Flat out taking the game over, and there's no way he's going to give it up.
Here's Forbes. Pass to Antetokounmpo. Here's Connaughton. And a great assist by Antetokounmpo. And that one goes in. Antetokounmpo's got 3 assists now in this one. Now here's Curry. Not a lot of room. Good on the shot. Curry's got 35.
What a performance on the offensive end. He's making the defenders pay right now for all of the mistakes they're making.
Middleton outside. Takes it inside. He can't get it to go. Good work defensively by Oubre. Pass to Pascal. From the right block. It's hauled in by Connaughton.
He'll have a hard time shaking that one off. Perfect position, plenty of space. Just clanked it.
Well, Grant Pat Connaughton showing off his 44-inch vertical leap in last season's dunk contest.
Show off indeed. And, of course, he likes to surprise people with his crazy bounce that he has. But you know what? He also throws a fastball in the high 90s. Connaughton's a lot more than meets the eye.
Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up.
That's why Middleton gets the respect from the teammates here. Adept at getting to the free throw line and attacking the inside.
Shooting 2.
First free throw is good. So it's both teams making substitutions here. Both free throws good from Middleton. Golden State has gotten 12 of their points this quarter from deep. 4 of 6. Here's Poole. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. First one falls for him. That one misses. The Bucks have gotten 6 of 10 shots to fall in this third quarter. Portis outside. And it's all tied up. Portis has got 9.
The defense couldn't collapse quickly enough.
Here's Wanamaker. Pass to Middleton. Now Augustine. A minute 58 left to play in the third. Down to 5 on the shot clock. For the lead! It's rebounded by Golden State. Chris has got 4 rebounds now. Pass to Poole. Here's Wanamaker. He's covered by Augustine. So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. It's going to be on DJ Augustine.
Man, the defender really went after him.
And he makes a first. Lopez, he's checked in for the Bucks. On both. Milwaukee with the ball. 2-point game. Here's Augustine. And the Bucks getting another bucket right there.
Once he breaks out the crossover, you just know something special is about to happen.
Here's the pick. Pass to Chris. Here's Wanamaker. 6 points for him. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
And I think it's time to put multiple bodies on him.
Three left in the third quarter of the game. Pass to Lopez. Portis with it, and Looney picks him up defensively. Outside Augustine. Here's Lopez, and the Bucks getting another bucket right there.
Lopez down on the inside, getting that soft touch to go.
Here's Wanamaker. Pass to Poole, launches it, fires in the triple. And the Warriors lead by four.
And not where he earns his money, that three-point shot. But he's a good shooter from that range if he's got space.
Lopez in the post. Here's Craig. Six on the shot clock. Outside Augustine. Tried to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Here's Toscano. And the Warriors with another three! And we've watched three so far in this one. The Warriors on top, they lead by seven. And coming up as soon as we return from break, the fourth quarter gets underway. And let's take this opportunity to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, just shredding the defense with that feed. Zero chance to stop that.
That's what great passing will do for you right there, dissecting the defense with that play.
With three quarters behind us, let's see what this fourth period holds in store. On the floor for the Warriors. Stephen Curry is out there with Andrew Wiggins. Then there's Eric Paschal. Then it's Wiseman. And it's Oubre in at the small forward position. Now here's Paschal. Shot clock at six.
Well, the D doesn't seem to be too worried about him from three-point range, and he shows us why still. I expect him to make one of those.
Here's Lopez. Antetokounmpo outside. Holiday finds Antetokounmpo.
Well, if he wants to make the defense work, he's got to start knocking down the threes. Only one so far in this game for him, and none since halftime.
Pass to Wiggins. And again, no good by Golden State.
Not his best night from the field, but looking for other ways and finding them so he can chip in.
Antetokounmpo with... Oh, hey! How about that?
That's impressive. I think Giannis loves that kind of stuff right there. His dunks sometimes get vicious.
Got a piece of it. Fourth quarter now. We're about a minute and a half in. On the wing, Holiday. He's covered by Curry. Pass to Lopez. DiVincenzo with it. Just fired to shoot. Antetokounmpo, a screen on Wiggins. And Giannis with the dunk.
More and more Giannis is getting the ball in late clock situations, so very calm in that one.
Curry against Holiday. They set the screen. Off target from three-point range. For Milwaukee, they've gone 2 of 3 to open the fourth quarter. Driving in. That one falls.
The Holiday focus there and a good job of scoring despite getting whacked.
And the Bucks making a change here. Middleton's checked in.
One shot.
That one drops. He ties it up.
I don't know if Drew Holiday's an underrated player, but he certainly is underappreciated with the way he can go at you as a two-way guy. He can score, and he can also guard positions 1 through 4.
They're just giving away a run right now. The question is, can they stop the tide?
Hard to say right now. At this point, I've seen the coaches run through 2 or 3 iterations of defense. Is there a fourth? I'm not sure.
Now here's Curry. Wiggins outside. Kicks it out to Pascal. The three. Rebounded by Lopez. Lopez has got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. Pass to DiVincenzo. Outside Holiday. Lopez passes to Holiday. Got a hand on it. Wiggins outside. Outside Curry. Wiggins outside. And Drew Holiday gets the whistle that time. That's his third foul so far. Outside Pascal. Pass to Oubre. Looking to end the drought. Hits the trifecta. And the Warriors lead by three.
Got to know the scouting report. You do not want Kelly Oubre to establish confidence in catch-and-shoot chances. Knocks it down.
Three-pointer is up. Middleton. The shot misses, so Golden State will take it the other way. They've led by as many as 14. Curry against Holiday. 14 feet away. That one off the back iron and out.
One reason this game is so tight is because both teams are hitting the boards with reckless abandon.
Pass to DiVincenzo. Oubre against Middleton.
This feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
Here's Wiseman. Back to Curry. Six on the shot clock. Lays it up and banks it in. And now it's a five-point Warrior lead.
Just one made basket for him here in the fourth, but it's a big one.
Middleton against Oubre. And he's going for the oop here. And the jam by Antetokounmpo.
Every night there's something that Giannis does on the floor where you just have to put your hands on your head. Wow, what a move.
Pass to Wiggins. Into the lane. Antetokounmpo with the block. It's Middleton on the wing. To the inside. And Antetokounmpo, the bucket on the assist by Middleton. Now just a one-point Warrior lead. Golden State has gone 1 for 5 from downtown here in the fourth. Pass to Pascal. Back to Curry. And he banks in the layup. Curry's got 39.
That's tough. Tough finish. Steph's not just a great shooter, but really great numbers through the years as being an elite finisher.
Now here's Lopez. Now here's Antetokounmpo. He takes it in, uses the glass to finish the layup. Antetokounmpo's got 16 points here in the second half.
And that was the right decision. When you're in need of a bucket, you go to your most trusted guys.
Yeah, whether it's teammates or the coaching staff, hopefully a combination of both, but when it gets close, he's getting the ball. He's not very hard to defend right now. This is when the defense might step back and let him try to find his range.
Inside, stolen by Wiggins. Outside Curry. And Dante DiVincenzo is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul. Connaughton, he's checked in for DiVincenzo. Pascal finds Oubre. Now Pascal. There's the triple. Rebound by Middleton.
Well, there's more he could have done in this game for sure, but it hasn't kept them from pulling ahead.
Holiday passes to Antetokounmpo.
And he's doing things on the glass tonight that we don't often see.
Well, this kind of effort will energize the team and get you going, just gobbling up every board.
Drops in the three.
And Steph Curry is a brilliant offensive basketball player. The D backs up, and he just shoots that one off the dribble.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. And now we present our New Balance player of the game, Stephen Curry.
This is special. We are witnessing a legendary performance here tonight. He is like levels above everyone else on the floor. Something must have clicked for him in warm-ups tonight. He's just come out and he has run wild.
to Lopez. And here is Antetokounmpo. Pascal defends. Curry against Holiday. And it's Wiseman with the rebound. Wiseman's got rebound number 13 tonight with that one. Wiggins passes to Curry. Off the mark there with a three. The Bucks have gotten 6 of 12 shots to go here in this fourth quarter. Antetokounmpo against Wiggins. Pass to Connaughton. Lopez with it. Beyond the arc. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Pascal's got 4 rebounds in the game. Here's Wiseman. Oubre with it. Outside Curry. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by Connaughton. And here's Middleton for three. They get the rebound. Antetokounmpo. Pass to Connaughton. The three ball. It's hauled in by Oubre.
Well, you make strides to get back in the ball game, but an errant shot like that can definitely cost you any kind of momentum. Have to use better judgment there.
Soft touch off the glass. Curry's got 9 points now in the quarter.
I don't know how he makes a shot like that look as easy as it did. So elite.
Oh, what ferocity on the throwdown. I just love when he goes up with purpose.
Where was the D right there? The effort lacking big time.
There's some ways to get your coach's attention, and that draws the coaching staff's ire.
Now here's Oubre. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
Oubre just being aggressive, and that's going to pay off on some free throw shooting attempts here.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 6-point ball game.
And the lead getting safer and safer as these free throws from the stripe go in.
Lopez, the screen. Antetokounmpo, bam!
How about Antetokounmpo rising up, shooting with great confidence, and drilling a three?
Holiday against Curry. They double-team Curry to the paint. Here's Wiseman, and so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. That's on Brook Lopez. First free throw is good, and that gives him a 4-point cushion. So both free throws good, and it's a 5-point game.
Big free throws right there to make this a 2-possession game.
Here's Antetokounmpo, and you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance at a 3-point play.
Well, not only being just an all-around more improved player, Giannis has taken some huge strides in terms of building his body up.
Those and-one plays can be real backbreakers in a close game.
Here's Golden State. They've led by as many as 14. And now they decide to foul intentionally. He hits the first one, and that makes it a 3-point lead.
And what you love about Steph right here is just the winning mentality. He's a champion that gives up a lot of his game in order for greater team success.
Second one is good, getting both at the line. And it's a 4-point ball game.
And right here, they can't waste any time.
Well, it's probably a little bit too late here, but you really need to score a bucket here to stay alive.
And now an intentional foul. They need the ball back as soon as possible.
Yeah, just a must-foul situation to stop the clock.
And that hurts as he doesn't get the first one to fall. Trying to focus now for the second. Now,
Kelly Oubre is a multi-talented forward that plays with a lot of confidence. If he can keep this kind of consistency, he's going to do some damage in this league.
And he does get the second one. And that puts him up five. Antetokounmpo for three. Warriors with the rebound. And now we've got an intentional foul.
Yeah, and there's no question they have to foul. Now, I'm sure they would have preferred to avoid it.
So the first one drops, and that increases the lead to six. So he gets them both, and it's a seven-point game. Here's Connaughton. Antetokounmpo. It's in.
Giannis down there in great position down low and good timing on the putback.
And so it's Golden State winning this one. Just a gutsy performance on the road.
It really was. When this one was up in the air late, they showed how tough-minded they are as a team.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Brent Berry, Grant Hill, and Ali LaForce, this is Brian Anderson. Thank you for watching this 2K Sports presentation of the NBA. So long, everybody.